Hello! Like my flag? I bought it in the video. We're gonna go over 4 thrift stores. I spent 150 bucks, and we're gonna highlight the rare, unique, and valuable items I found because, as many of you know, I make a large portion of my income from reselling used items I get at garage sales, thrift stores, pallets, wherever. This video is a little bit longer, so maybe pause it right now, go to the kitchen, get a snack, and sit down because I think you're gonna find this both informative and fun to watch. The first thing I look for when I go into a thrift store is the electronics section. I sell a lot of electronics. They can be old, obsolete VCRs, DVD-VCR combos. What you saw earlier is a Leapfrog kids tablet. This is kind of an underrated niche, I think. It's more difficult to sell on Amazon because there's a gating process, but on eBay, if you can get it cheap enough and you have the right items, these still are worth selling. So what you're gonna wanna do is look at the model number. I'm gonna show you a few on the side of the screen right here. It's easy to do. Go to eBay, go to sold listings, and you can see, like, yes, old media players are still worth money. Cameras, even mouses or keyboards, these things are all worth money, and lots of thrift stores are gonna have these. You have to go there and look it up, but once you have an idea for what sells, your job becomes a whole lot easier, and you begin building mental lists of what your go-to items are. I'm also looking at clocks, their electronics as well, but what I've noticed over the past year is on Amazon especially, a lot of these old legacy listings, I guess you might call them, the older iHome, or Timex, or Sony Dream Machine clock, the pages on Amazon, they've been taken down for various reasons. And so unfortunately, there are a lot fewer things to sell in this category on Amazon, but still, like this Timex blue clock that you see on the screen, that still sells pretty well on eBay, even though I'm sure previously on Amazon, it would have gone for probably 80 bucks. Besides electronics, there's also, it's like the knick-knack section where they have everything in these bins, these wire bins. I'm always digging around in there, looking for products that are new, old stock, or just seem unique in any way. There's some Dr. Scholl's inserts. I put those back. They went for about 15, 20 bucks on eBay, but not really what I'm looking for. I'm looking for higher value things that might sell a little bit faster. There's a pretty cool Michigan flag. You can see it over there. I bought that. I'm not gonna sell the Michigan flag. I'm just gonna keep it. But that's the fun in this. If you find things you like, you can just keep them. I try and sell pretty much everything that I buy, but still, if I find something in there that catches my eye, a hidden treasure, I'll definitely keep it. I'll switch over to just audio now so you can get a better idea of what's on screen. So I'm looking around, rummaging through here, some old binoculars. Nothing really catching my eye. Go down here. That's just like some paper stuff. This looks cool. Whenever I see a zipper container, I'm going to open that up. I want to know what's inside, even if it's kind of difficult to do with one hand. What this ended up being was a harmonica set. The brand was Hohner or Horner or something like that. Roadhouse Blues harmonicas. These sell in used condition for about 20 bucks. So this is on the edge if I'm actually going to buy it. It was $5 in the store. There is a small profit on there, but what I do is I try and make at least 20 bucks per item. This goes, you know, I'm thinking about it, goes in the cart. Both of these things right here, although they would sell for a small profit, it's just not worth it for me to buy it. This fig pin, however, it's a Naruto fig pin. They want 2 bucks there. It's going to go for about 20 bucks online. So even though that's below my minimum threshold, things that are so easy to ship and aren't going to, you know, I might get back harmonicas. I'm never going to get a fig pin returned. A lot of the things here are just not worth selling. You know, some kids' face masks, picture frame, interesting stuff. This AccuShot, it's like it holds a scope for a gun. I thought about this. They wanted 4 bucks for it. It would have gone for between 15 and 20 bucks probably. But again, I'm just going to keep the Naruto fig pin because that should be the easiest sale. This stuff's cool too. So these are hand-painted Day of the Dead salt shakers. And this is a polished metal. I don't think it's tin. The top screw cap is tin, but I couldn't figure out what the metal was. I thought maybe both of those might be worth selling, but again, probably wouldn't get more than 15 bucks for any of them. For me to sell anything in this section of the store, it has to be a home run, basically, because I don't know it that well. I don't want to sit in my warehouse. The things that might break, that's even more of a nightmare for me because I am kind of clumsy, I'm not going to lie. So these, very cool. Very, very cool. These are made in Holland,
I can't pronounce the name, but I'll put it on the screen. Jefferson Cup. So they're pewter cups. If they were all in great condition, I would have bought them, even though they are not that profitable. They wanted, let's see, about $13 for these. It said it was a set of seven. I could only find six. That kind of worried me, but they were just very dirty. The brand, they're made in Holland. The brand was like Dabberdahl or Rabberall. I couldn't find a lot of those for sale. Probably on eBay, it goes for about $35. I think on Etsy, you could get like $50 for it. If I had an antique booth, I'd be a lot more likely to buy those. But instead, they stay on the shelf. Very cool item. But I think it's better for someone else to buy than me.
So I rarely sell clothing, but this, I saw it across the store. It's a cardigan with leather elbow patches, vintage Eddie Bauer, made in USA. They want $11 for it. Again, it has to be, it's like the breakable homemade good stuff. It has to be a home run. I should be able to get about $80 for this. It's kind of risky, but it's very cold out, very unique and very good condition. Nothing else here really caught my eye. The orange camo stuff, maybe I thought I could find a Pendleton or a nice brand like button shirt. Couldn't find any. No really cool vintage t-shirts, although Shorts is a pretty cool brewery, just not worth much money. Those are worth nothing. Again, like I said, there might be some full-time clothing sellers who would have eaten this up, but that's not me, so I left it on the shelf. Over to toys, I have a pretty basic strategy for toys. I'm looking for educational toys, toys that are interactive, not dropping them. anything that's going to make, you know, a kid engage with it. Those seem to be the ones that have the best resale value. I'm also looking for new in-box puzzles or race cars or stuff like that. These two new in-box puzzles, they probably are not going to sell very fast. I will sell them on Amazon. The sales rank is very high, like above 700,000, but there's also no competition. So it's one of those things where it might take a year to sell, but I'm turning $5 into probably $60 around there. And so it ends up being, in my opinion, a winning equation. This Power Rangers toy, I thought about it long and hard. So it's a newer model. It was made in 2019. I don't know what era of Power Rangers that is. Put it in the cart, looked it up, ended up not being worth buying. These Dr. Seuss books, I thought they may be old, maybe vintage Dr. Seuss. That is worth selling. The vintage kids book market has kind of gone off the rails over the past 2 years. There's some very valuable stuff, but those were not it. This is a Fisher-Price Imaginext Eagle Talon Castle or Dragon or something like that. Eagle Talon Dragon. It works fine enough. The batteries were dead, so I'll take it home, put batteries in there, but that should go for about $40. This is a reproduction Fisher-Price Family Play Farm, what it says. Full of some stuff. It's like a lunchbox. There's some toys in there. Put it in the cart, looked it up, but it was probably only going for about $20, and so that's not really worth my time. Again, anything that I think kids might engage with, that's what I'm looking for. This is a Spin Master Dragon toy. I couldn't tell if it was missing parts. I don't think it is, but I'm not 100% sure. It goes used for about $15. This is like a Thor. I think they're 12 or 13 inch toys. That's how you look them up on eBay. But they're not very well made, so they're not worth that much. Some of the older ones, some of the Star Wars ones, those are worth buying. But even though they're in my cart, I did not end up purchasing them. This is why I love doing thrift store stuff, because what you're seeing on the screen, the artist's name is Sue Daw, Susan Daw. And if you Google her, she's a lady out in California who just loves doing fantasy airbrush painting and writing. And she's an art teacher at a local college over there. And I would have not known of any of this if I hadn't gone to the thrift store and looked up who this was and what they do. Now, even though this item isn't profitable, it's still really cool. I probably could have got $40 for this, maybe. This woman, Sue Daw, has a prodigious amount of art for sale on eBay from reproductions or whatever it is, and the ones that do sell are like on lacquered wood. This was just a print. It's still very, very cool, but if I hadn't gone to this store and bought these things to resell and searched stuff out and looked at the paintings, I would not have known about this. And just like I like learning little intricacies of recent history, to me that's cool.
if you want to buy this, it's in Ann Arbor. It's still for sale. No, I don't know if it's going to go. This is the kind of thing that people really love. They don't want to pay a lot of money for it, but like they love it. And just like knowing these things exist makes me a little bit happier. On to the next store. I'm going to stay on screen while I do the electronics. If you don't like me on screen, comment below. I would love to hear how I can make these videos better. I want you to be entertained while you're still learning stuff. Scanning electronics, looking up my model number, all that stuff, it's kind of boring, but it's one of the most reliable ways that I make resale money, so I think it's worth talking about and showing what I go for. Now, unfortunately here, this media player I found, I could not find the exact same listing on Amazon, and it only goes for about $35 on eBay, so even though it's in my cart, I did not end up buying it. And these video games that you're gonna see, those I thought maybe, like, I've been selling video games for a long time, a lot longer than a lot of people have been doing eBay stuff. And so I have a good idea for what titles are worth more than like $4 or $5 plus shipping. These were not them. I thought they might be. You know, obviously you're gonna see all your old sports games that are worthless, but these were like not one-off titles, but just more unique titles. But still, they're only going for about like $3 or $4 plus shipping on Amazon, and that's not worth the money they were trying to get for them. I think what's happening at this Salvation Army and a lot of them in my area is they are beginning to cherry pick the good stuff off the donations and sell it themselves. That sucks for resellers, but that's the way it is. You know, you can't expect everything always to be the same. You have to adapt to it and expand your markets, and that's what I'm trying to do. That's why I'm over here at Mugs.
I don't know the most about mugs, but I am learning. One of the brands I know is great is Ray Dunn. And this Bah Humbug Ray Dunn Christmas mug, which is half off at the store today, still has the sticker on it. I think I should probably get about $40 for it. I'm not totally sure. I'll make sure to be very careful when I package it. I think it was a good find. What I also found in this store was right here, this guy, Wes. Wes is a reseller. Always good to see a friendly face out in the stores. When we were talking, Wes told me about a really valuable hat he had found, so I said, you know what, I'll check it out too. I'll try and find a hat. I thought this Duluth Trading Co. hat might have been worth some money, but having Wixom on there kind of removed any of the value. I thought this St. Louis Cardinals hat might have been worth some money. It wasn't. It wasn't the right brand. It wasn't the right style. So even if you've been doing this for a long time like I have, there's still a lot you can learn. You don't have to be perfect. You know, sometimes you're going to knock things over like I did just right there. Sometimes you're going to make mistakes, but as long as you're always learning, that's what matters. I saw a Matt Stafford jersey. He is the Detroit Lions ex-quarterback. We traded him. Still really loved by people here. This got donated because he's out in LA now. They wanted, $13 for it. It should sell for $40. Not the meatiest margin, but it will ship USPS first class mail, so I think it was worth buying. I looked through some more clothing here. Didn't see anything that was priced right. That Carhartt maybe was okay. They said it was a large. I think it's a youth large. It looked very, very small to me. But I didn't know the details of it, so when in doubt, just put it back. It's okay to put things back. What you don't want to do, and what I was guilty of earlier in my reselling career, was buying things without being absolutely sure what I knew what it was. I said, oh, everyone else is doing this. They're buying tons of clothes. I should buy tons of clothes too. And that's just not a good way to start. You want to be more certain than you think you have to be. Like this right here, this Wrangler pearl button shirt. 4 years ago, I would have bought that, but I left it because, you know what? I have so much inventory that I don't need to have more on my plate. It's really difficult to know when to buy things and when not to buy things. And so, like I said, if you ever have worries about it, if you ever have apprehension, don't feel bad to put it back. Don't feel like you missed out because you probably didn't. You're just learning. This was kind of odd. Over in the book section, a lot of new in box board games and puzzles. That's Operation Escape Evil. Should get about $30 for that. This is the Next Big Thing game. Should get about $50 for that. Work from home survival kit, not worth anything. Funny, ha ha ha, but it's like a gag gift. Gag gifts do not really have a lot of value long term. Bruce Tegner method of self-defense. That book, we'll talk about it later. These two puzzles, I could not find a listing on Amazon, and on eBay they go for about 15, 20 bucks. So even though they go in the cart, they went back on the shelf after I looked it up. So all these books here, including the Bruce Tegner method, I scan the barcode, or I scan the cover, or I look up with the ISBN number. The Bruce Tegner book is probably not worth more than $15. So why did I buy it? Because I thought it was cool. I think old stuff is cool. You know, sue me. This, my first Craftsman circular saw, that's a kid's toy, not a real saw, obviously. That'll go on eBay because of how much box damage there is. I just want the buyer to be totally aware of what they're buying. And on eBay, you can take more pictures and just be a bit more full with your description. This is our third Salvation Army. You might notice I'm not going to Goodwills. That's because around me, the Goodwills do not have good stuff, so I just avoid them. At this Salvation Army, again, we're doing electronics. A lot of the stuff here was not as good. It really is hit or miss. One of the cool things that I saw here that I haven't seen at other stores, but is always something I look out for, is a hand crank weather radio. This hand crank weather radio, the brand is GPX. And if you know anything about electronics, GPX is not a very valuable brand, but this specific product, the hand crank weather radio, is almost always looking up no matter what the brand is, because it's such a functional device that even though it might be GPX, people still want it, and you still see them going for between $40 and sometimes over $100. This is a low-end one, so only 40 bucks, but they want a few bucks for it. It's worth it. I might even keep this. I don't have one in my car. I want one. I tested it in the store. It works fine. And just like anything that's hand-powered or manual-powered, for some reason, I think that stuff's cool. Everything I put in my cart right here, I ended up putting back on the shelf because it either didn't work or I couldn't find the correct Amazon listing, and on eBay they went for under 20 bucks. A lot of the stuff here is kind of junk. Nothing that's like that great. Maybe the Spider-Man helicopter if it was new, but clearly it's not new. A lot of the stuff was just broken and doesn't work. This is kind of cool. I mean, obviously I didn't buy it. I have no clue if it's complete. Solid bronze collector coins. That was kind of neat. They wanted 25 bucks for it. They were all out of their original case, and I would not doubt if some fell out of the back of this picture frame. I don't know. Just kind of cool. Thought I'd share with you guys what I saw there. I went over to Mugs to see if I could have my same Ray Dunn luck. I did not have the same luck, but I did see kind of a cool The Office Dwight False mug. Only worth $10 or $12. Again, you know, not every thrift store is going to be a home run. You just have to kind of accept that. Over in the kitchen area, I saw a really cool cast iron Dutch oven. It's 3.7 liters, I believe. Is that, yeah, 3.5 liters. Not the best condition, but still definitely salvageable. It's Uno Masa, I think is the brand name. These go for about, or Uno Casa, not Masa, Uno Casa, one house in Spanish. They go for about 60 bucks used. They're very heavy. They wanted 15 bucks in the store. I figured, you know what, I'll leave it here. Somebody can really use that. I already have one at home, so unfortunately, not profitable. So my camera died. Here's what I got at the last store, a few toys, two of these Beat Bell Beat Bow toys, an Elmo toy. A Timex clock and that GPX radio. I'll update that. I should get about probably 100 bucks for those three toys. So that's the new additional items I bought. Let's go into the store now to see what we have here. This Salvation Army is a little bit different. They have like a small electronic section. I picked up this calculator. Sometimes these small printable calculators, like accounting calculators, do fine, make, you know, 40, 50 bucks in them. That one, the brand was not selling. This is interesting, a talking heart rate monitor from Oregon Scientific, new in package, 7 bucks for it. There are no listings on Amazon, no active listings, there's an existing ASIN. So I think I'll price that at 50 bucks, but I don't know if that's going to be too much. My strategy is always price high because it's a lot easier to lower the price than to raise the price. That giant Sudoku handheld game would have been great if I had the hand stylus. I did not have the hand stylus. It seems a lot of these small electronics here are missing parts.
finally, our first DVD VCR combo of the day, and they only want $9. That is a great deal for my area. That one's going on Amazon. The sales rank's about 300,000, so it might take a little bit to sell, but I should get about 90 bucks for it. I'm looking for more clocks, any Timex, any iHome, any Sony, any Philips brand stuff, and I'm going to look them up. Unfortunately, that also that I put in the cart, that one was not going to be profitable. It sells for about $18 on Amazon, and after the cost of my product, after fees, after shipping, I'd make like $2. It is not worth it. So here's a brand I don't usually sell. That's Sharp. What drew my eye to it was it's a projection alarm clock. Those are usually worth looking up. Even a less popular brand like Sharp is still going to have some resale value. That one sells for about 45 bucks on Amazon. That's where I'll be selling it. I did not check eBay comps, but I'm sure they are quite a bit lower because with those not off brands, but less valuable brands, there generally is a pretty steep decline in the price on Amazon. This is a Sony Blu-ray player. Would not sell on eBay, but because I'm on Amazon, I can sell it. I will. I'll get about 60 bucks for it. So far, I'm doing pretty good. We're already over $1,300. I've taken 4 hours to do this thrifting. The video is taking like 8 hours to edit, so I hope you guys appreciate this because it certainly is not in my best interest to make these from a financial standpoint. I'm in toys now. This is a breakdancing duck. B-boy style duck. I looked it up on Amazon, couldn't find anything on eBay. It was going for like 15 bucks, so I put it back. I'm trying to find just anything that's new in package right now, maybe some more kids toys, any action figures. Handheld games are here sometimes. This Ryobi, it's like a rechargeable battery radio. They wanted 50 bucks for it. Used sells for about $75. I thought maybe it could be worth it. I wasn't sure also if it was missing a part or if it had to come with a battery to be resold. So even though it's in the cart, I put it back. I thought I had a good find with this Buzz Lightyear toy, but unfortunately missing the face shield. You have to have a complete toy to get some good money for it. So even though this is the older model, it looks like still no face shield. So unfortunately, it goes back on the shelf. The final area I'm checking out is clothing. I saw a Duluth Trading Co. Fleece-lined snap button shirt. They want 20 bucks for it, worth about 35, 40, so it's going back on the rack. But I'm still going to look for anything interesting. Maybe I can find some cool vintage t-shirts. I have not had a lot of luck trying to find those in the past few years, but every once in a while, you do get lucky. That is a old Green Day t-shirt. There was a cool Cheers t-shirt. I looked that one up. It was going for about $15, so it did not go. I didn't buy it. I just put it on the rack. Now, this is kind of cool. This is the brand is Humanities on a vintage Toltex tag or Tooltex. I don't know how you say it. I ended up finding two of these. That's a little panda bear in the pocket with some eucalyptus. That's what they eat, right? Some old Levi's, but I'm not gonna buy jeans that take 18 minutes to list and I can make $6 on. I'm not in the mood to do that. It's not how my business functions. But these t-shirts, the earlier Humanity t-shirt, and then I'm going to find one in a second you're going to see as well. I did buy both of these, and I think I'm going to price them both at 40 bucks a piece because that seems to be like what you can get for cool, unique, vintage t-shirts. I would not pay that for these, but I've sold enough over the years where that's just kind of where the market's settling. If you have a unique t-shirt and the graphics are clean, like this one says Born to be Wild, old vintage tag. Somebody wants that. They're also, the size is extra large. That helps the resale value as well. Will they both go for 40 bucks a piece? Maybe. I'm going to list them on eBay and Mercari. I've had a lot of luck on Mercari selling those. All the other clothing here just doesn't really catch my eye. That's a local high school, the Brighton Bulldogs. Cool, you know, full camo stuff. But again, when I sell these things that are not my normal toys or electronics or DVDs, it really does have to be like a unique thing that I think is cool and will probably sell. Those Humanities, I think they'll sell. I mean, obviously, if you think I'm wrong, correct me in the comments. But in my experience, that kind of niche novel stuff with clean graphics does usually sell. Let's do a quick rundown of what the estimated profit is, because that $1,390 you saw on the screen, that is just the revenue. That doesn't take into account the costs I had or marketplace fees or shipping. So generally, marketplace fees and shipping are about one-third of total revenue. So we're going to keep that into account after we do our minusing from the cost I spent and gas as well. So I'll say I spent $20 in gas. It was probably more like $10 in gas, but just I didn't keep track of the mileage, so we'll round up. So $13.90 minus $150 for the cost of buying items minus $20 for gas is $1,220. Minus a third of our total revenue, which is about $460, gives us a total profit of $761.70. All in all, not bad. Let's take it a step further though. Am I making more money off this YouTube video than I will off the items that sell? No, probably not. This video would have to get between 30 and 40,000 views to equal the amount of money I would make selling the stuff. How long will it take to sell? Most likely I will sell half of what I bought in the first month, and then I'll sell about 90% in the first 4 months, and then over the next year, that remaining 10% will sell. That's just what I do. It's not like a rule for everyone, but me doing this for so long, I noticed trends that I have. And so that's not, like I said, what's going to happen to you maybe if you buy all a bunch of garbage that's never going to sell. But just based on how I source, I should have definitely break even in a few days and then see a pretty sizable profit in the month. And then just it snowballs over the next year. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like this, subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, down below is where you go. And don't worry, I have more videos for you like that one right there. I think you're going to like it.